Hello everyone, welcome to WebSense Pro. I'm your host Bilal Nasir again with a new tutorial, and this tutorial is related to WooCommerce store. So what we're gonna do, we'll add nice looking color swatches in our WooCommerce store, just like the store which I have. So as you can see, we have nice looking swatches showing up on the product archive page, and when I click on any of the swatch, it changes the color of the image of the product. And if we go to the single product page template, you can see we have nice looking color swatches showing up, and the size variant is also really clean looking with the boxes. So by default, WooCommerce product archive page looks like this, where it doesn't show what type of variants the specific product have. And when we go to the single product page, you can see that we have these drop down menus for the variants. So if you want to learn how to add swatches to your WooCommerce store and make your product page look more attractive, keep watching the video. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel, comment on the video below if you want me to create more videos for you guys. So without further ado, let's get into implementing this tutorial. Okay guys, so that's the default layout of WooCommerce store, where it doesn't have any variation swatches or size variant showing up. It just have select option button, where you'll need to click on select options, and then you will see the drop down menu of color and sizes, or if you have any other variations. And what we're gonna do, we'll add a free plugin called Variation Swatches for WooCommerce by Cart Flows. So in order to add that plugin, go to the dashboard of your WooCommerce website, and from there we'll add a new plugin. And this plugin is by Cart Flows, so you can directly search for Cart Flows. Here we have Variation Swatches for WooCommerce by Cart Flows plugin showing up. Click on install now. And activate the plugin. After activating the plugin, now let's add a new product, add variations, and then add the swatches to that product. Click on products and then add new. And now I'm going to add a new product called crop top. From product data drop down menu, select variable product. Click on attributes. From this drop down custom product attribute, click add. Add your size attribute, and in size attribute we'll have large, medium, small, and we will use this attribute for variations. Click on that checkbox. Click on save attributes, then add another custom product attribute for the colors. Color, don't forget to check mark the use for variation checkbox. Add your colors. So in this product, we'll have white, blue, and yellow as our color. Click on save attributes. And publish the product. After publishing the product, you can click on swatches. So this option will only show up when you will have that plugin activated. Otherwise, it's not going to show up. Now click on swatches. And from there, you can see we have color, and we can define the attribute type to color. For size, we can define the attribute type to label. Okay, now expand the color, and as you can see, it's showing the three options which we added. Now for white, we'll select the white color. For blue, we'll select the blue color. And for the yellow, we'll select the yellow color. Okay, now hit save. And now let's add in our variations. From Variations tab, this drop-down will show up. And from there, click on Create Variations from All Attributes. After selecting this, click on Go. It will show up small pop-up. Click OK. Now it's another alert which says that 9 variations has been added. Cool. Okay, our variations has been added. Now I'm going to add the default price for all of them. Set regular price. Now it will add $20 to all of the variations. Click on OK. Select the category. Click Update. And now let's check out our product. Okay. Our product is showing up with the size, variance, and the color swatches. Looks cool, right? Now let's add in the featured image of the product and add in the different image for each variant or each color. I'm going to add the featured image. So that's the product image, which is also called featured image. Let's select this as a featured image. And now I'm going to add product gallery images, blue and white. And now let's add in different color for a specific variant. So if someone click on blue color, it will show up the blue picture. And when someone click on yellow color, it will show up the yellow picture. And when click selected on white, it will show the white product picture. In order to do that, click on variations. And then as you can see, we'll have to add the image for every single color. So for example, for white, I'm going to select the white image. For blue, I'm going to select blue image. For yellow, I'm going to select the yellow image. Okay, I'm going to pause the video and add all of the colors. Okay guys, I've added all of the colors as per the variant. And now I'm going to click on update. After updating the product page, I'm going to go to the product page and hit refresh to see how the product page looks like. And now, when we select size and then colors, it will change the picture. So for example, we are on large. And when I click on blue, it changes the picture to blue. And when I select the yellow one, it shows the product picture as the yellow one. Similarly, if I go to the product archive page, it will have the same behavior. So that's the product which I added called crop top. Now if I select the size and change the color, it will change the picture and show up that specific variant picture. Looks cool, right? So that's how we can add swatches. There's another method which we can use in that plugin, which I'm going to show you how. In that method, we can set up attributes and variations for products at once for all of the products. So in order to do that, let's go to dashboard. And from there, hover on products and then attributes. And from there, I'm going to add a new attribute called size. Enable in archives, custom ordering. Type is label, size is label. click on add attribute. And when the attribute is added, we will set up the terms by clicking on configure terms. And here I'm going to add my three sizes, large, medium, and small. Large. Medium. Small. Okay, we have our terms configured. Now I'm going to click on attributes again and set up the color attribute. Make sure to check that enable archives. And from type, we'll select color. And shape, we can select any shape, circle, square, or rounded corner. Let's select square for this one. Okay, we can also select size. Let's leave it for that now, which we can change on later. Click on add attribute. And now I'm going to configure the terms for color. Click on configure terms. And in that, we'll add our three colors which we have in our product. Blue, select it as blue. Click on add new color. Similarly, add another color, white. Select the color. Click on add new color. And finally, we'll all set up our last color, which is yellow. Select yellow from the colors. Click on add new color. Okay, our terms have been added for size and color variation. Now what we're going to do, click on edit product. And from there, first we will delete all the variations which we added in that product, because now we have added our attributes globally, which we can add to all of our products really easily. And I'm going to show you guys how. So from the product settings, first I'm going to delete all the variations which I previously created. So delete all the variations from here. And then delete these attributes which I created for the product. And now when I click on this drop down menu, you can see we have already showing up color and size. So add in color and size. And now we will have values showing up already. So when I click here, you can see that we have the color showing up, and we can select the colors which we have available in this product. So we have these three colors in this product. I'm going to select all of them. Click on use for variations. And for size, it will show all of the terms which we added, large, medium, small. So for example, in this product, if we just have large and small, we don't have medium available. So we'll just select large and small. Don't forget to check that use for variation checkmark. Click on save attributes. And then go to variations. Create variations from all attributes. Okay. Our variations has been added. And from variations, we'll again select all of the images for that specific color. So for example, blue one will have blue image. Blue, white, yellow. Hit save changes after adding after selecting the picture for each color. And now when we hit update, and add the pricing, click on variations, select set regular prices, add in the price, hit update, and now let's view our product. Here we go. Our product variation swatches are showing up. Each color is showing a different image for that product. Similarly, in product archive page, it will show up the color swatches and sizes. So as you can see, it automatically added the colors in the box style for the products where the colors are already added. Similarly for this product, we already have colors added in that, so it converted into swatches. So that's the benefit of adding the swatches using product attributes, which will set up the global settings, and you won't have to add sizes and colors manually on every single product. So that's the easy way to add swatches and size color attributes for all of your products. So that's it for the tutorial, guys. Plugin have a lot of settings, and it's gonna take a lot of time to walk through all of the plugin settings. I just wanted to show you guys how you can add swatches and sizes to your product and make it look good to make your WooCommerce store more presentable. If you like the video, don't forget to like it, comment on the video below, and let me know what more you would like to learn. Until then, have a great day.